Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I will be going from my hostel to the Songjiang district, which is very far south of Shanghai, and there I will be visiting a few places. And so let's go guys. So now we are inside the subway of line 9, and we have to go all the way down here to the Zuibaiche. It's my first stop, and if you're coming here from somewhere in the center, it will take you around 45 to 1 hour. And we started from here, Sujiahui. I arrived here at the Zuibaiche Gongyuan. So literally translated, this one here means Zui, basically drunk, Bai is white, and Che is lake, so it would be the drunk white lake. And here, okay, this is only the Chukou, only the entrance, but let's see where you can get in, maybe all, okay, here, Jinko. And I'm here with two friends today, and according to this guide here, this Gongyuan was built from 1644 to 1722, and let's see, let's go inside. Now inside the park here, and the entrance is 12 yuan, so Piaojia Shea Yuan. And here you got these public newspapers, which you can see at many places in China. They have these billboards for just the public newspapers. And yeah, now today the goal for me is inside this park is to find out why it's called the Drunk White Lake Park. So let's see. Here got a quite nice wood carving, and I know now why this park here is called Zuibaiche Gongyuan, and it is because this park was built in order to honor Li Bai, a very famous author in Gudai Hanyu, in ancient China, Gudai Zhongguo. And yeah, because Li Bai also liked to drink alcohol, so they called it like the Drunk Bai Lake Park, I think.
Well, the correct explanation I found is this one here, and it says, during the Qing Dynasty, it belonged to Gu Dasheng, a famous artist, and he is responsible for its name. Namely, he was a great admirer of the poet Li Bai, so he named him the garden Zuibaiche, which means that if Li Bai ever visited this garden, he wouldn't wish to leave, but would stay there. And there's also a Chinese word which says, which is mi tsui, which means basically like to be lost or drunk or to be intoxicated. And this could express like if Li Bai would come to this area here, he finds it so beautiful and he gets lost in this beautifulness and it's in the scenery, so he doesn't want to leave.
And inside this park you can see this here with these very old characters, and if you look at these characters, I think I'm very happy that I learned now Chinese and not like 200, 300 years ago, because they look very complicated. And what we figured out here is that here's written Sue Hao Kongzi, and yeah, Sue means like study good, Confucius. And inside this character, all this meaning is included. So you have Hao here, and then Sue is when you take the front, and then this Zi, and Kongzi, so Confucius, so study good Confucius. But here the other ones I didn't figure out. And let's continue here. I think very interesting is that Shanghai itself, the city as we know today, doesn't have such a long history, but some parts of Shanghai are indeed quite old. So we are here now in front of this old artist. His name is Dong Qichang from 1555 until 1636, and he used to live here in Songjianghua, I don't know, Jin Shanghai. So from the old part, from like here, the southeast of Shanghai, and I can show you inside what the place looked like. So here during the Qing Dai Jiaqing, during the Songjiang Fuzhe, so the Qing Dai, during the Qing Dynasty, already this Songjiang Fuzhang existed. So yeah, already like 400 years of this place, but nowadays you cannot see this the city wall of this Songjiang Fuzhang anymore. But some ancient parts of this place you can still find here. And here you can see some of the art of Dong Qichang from 1602. Okay. I think these here are more of his, like Shuhua, but no, this one is, yeah, okay, also from Dong Qichang. So this whole exhibition is, I think, his paintings and his artworks. And here you can see Ming Dynasty. So I think this Dong Qichang, he lived at the end of the Ming Dynasty, maybe also into the Qing Dynasty. Yeah. And as I think many Chinese paintings, they have like a painting, like maybe a landscape, and also a small part which tells a story. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, look at this park. Also a very beautiful garden here again, and it's one of the four most famous parks in Shanghai. I think it is this one here, then the Yuyuan, then maybe Guiyuan, and the last one I don't know. And you have here nearby, also in Songjiangqu, you have a very old place where they in the 1950s, where like Chinese soldiers found a few very old things, and so you have also a museum there of all old goods, like old vases and pots, which date back to 4,000 years of 4,000 years before. So also 4,000 years before people lived here around Shanghai. And because this park here is quite far out of the Shanghai downtown, so you need to commit here by public transportation, maybe like almost 1 hour. So that's why it's here also quite empty, but still very nice. And if you want, you can come here with friends and sit down and drink tea or something else. Yeah, just walk around, look at all the nice round entrances. Yeah. And here you get a lotus flower. Well, this one is really pretty. Liano, I think, yes. Maybe the most famous flower, most important flower in China, or for China. And here again, the statue of Dongqichang. And this garden here is very huge, so you can spend a lot of time in here. So I was wrong about the name. So the name here, this place was only called like this Suibaiche, because the person who built or created this park here, this was his name, so it doesn't have anything to do, or this park wasn't made for to honor Li Bai. And here you can see like students. Bushimegoren, was it Dogoren? Nina, Nisha Jongoren ma. How sang she? Okay. Good. Okay, and they're drawing things here. Okay, but interesting. Hello. Hello. Okay. Okay, let's go back. Okay, well, I